So World Ocean Day is held on the 8th of June every year, and it's basically a day that we can use to inform people on the human impacts of the ocean and also to mobilise people on how they can help the oceans and conserve them, and also to push for sustainable management and conservation of the oceans. This year the theme is revitalisation and working together. So there's a big push at the moment for a thing called 30 by 30, which is 30% of land and sea of the planet protected by 2030. And that will deliver really important benefits, both in terms of climate resilience, biodiversity protection, and fisheries or food security. So National Geographic's Pristine Seas have been working with communities, policy makers and stakeholders to help inform the protection of their waters. Since 2008, they've helped to protect 26 marine reserves, and that includes over 6.5 million square kilometres of our oceans. The ocean actually has incredible resilience if it's given the opportunity to rebound. But if we have these multiple stresses on it, then it becomes really hard for that to happen. So overfishing is a huge impact on the ocean. Climate change is a huge impact. Pollution is a huge impact. But if we can start to take some of these impacts out from an area, then that gives that area an opportunity to rebound. So some personal things that people can do to reduce their impacts on the ocean are being conscious of what you eat. So if you are eating fish, make sure it comes from a sustainable source and that the fishing method isn't one that's too destructive. Pollution obviously is a big one as well. So both carbon output and also waste like plastics can have a huge impact on the ocean. So if we can reduce them in any way, then that's also a great help.